Distributing them here at the Patriots and at Blackhawk. so we're thankful to those of you who donated for those masks.
If you'd like to participate in the joint card that is in the art text, and you want to, those donations go toward car purchases. Our Christmas Eve worship services are at 4 and 10 p.m. on Saturday, with a string prelude with prayers at 10:30 and 9:30. So please join us Christmas Eve for worship. And then also Christmas Day worship will be at 9:15. And following our service on Christmas Day, we will have some coffee fellowship hosted by Pastor Jerry and Los Angeles in this Sunday. So if you would like to sit around for a little bit after worship on Christmas Day, we'll all be able to do so as well. Just stand if you're able and turn to your bulletin as we now gather and we pause for our reading of worship.
mercy.
Holy One, you have walked among us and we have seen a great light.
Lord, have mercy.
Rejoice, Emmanuel has come among us. The joy of the Lord is our strength.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Stir your power, Lord Christ, and come. With your abundant grace and might, free us from the sin that hinders our faith, that eagerly we may receive your promises. For you live, reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated for the lining of our family. We hear the angel come closer, not to be afraid. There is an alternative to the way we are in the world. We are praying many things this day as we journey to the manger. We don't know how things are going to change, but things change with the birth of Christ.
Who will speak words of hope to a world that oppresses the poor, the needy, and the widow? Where is the angelic voice offering encouragement?
The prophets see silver branches that will grow from the cut down tree of life. What has been cut down and cut out lies leaves us afraid. The being of the Lord is speaking to us this day.
We light this candle as a sign of our hope. The message of the angel encourages us.
the reckless, hopeless, desperate midst of his fallen creation. God sent not a giant, but a helpless infant. Not an armored warrior, but a baby, vulnerable and small.
Into hearts that could refuse him, and hands that would refuse him, God sent his most fragile and yet his most powerful gift, his love incarnate, the light of the world.
Thank you.
shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were so afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
Thank you.
He rose on high to eternal life. Then he turned and extended his life everlasting back to us.
And this is Christmas. This is what the world has been searching for. Not nostalgic memories or good feelings or even peace on earth, goodwill toward men. What we're searching for at Christmas is hope. And that hope is with love. Perhaps your life
Dave is moving to Davenport this week, and he'll be closer to his family, his dad and brother, and we're grateful for Dave. Dave, I've been here with you for 15 years, you've been here a lot longer, and I'm very grateful that God has created you and has blessed the congregation, has blessed us, blessed me with your council leadership while I first started here, and was very encouraging of our time together on church council, your faithfulness with Connie, and the joy and love of your marriage and the blessing of gathering here in the atrium with your family, the testament to your marriage. And then the Spirit that continues to empower us. So I just want to thank you for your love and kindness and faithfulness to God's grace and mercy. So let us offer a word of prayer as we have. We give you thanks, O Lord, for the silence between the notes, between the seasons of music that are in our lives. And we give you thanks, O Lord, for your faithfulness to us, especially this day for David, and ask you to watch over and bless his journey, his new home, that he may, in his strength and health, continue to be a blessing to your community of faith wherever it gathers. Guide him and bless him, we pray in Jesus' name, and all God's people send.
Amen.
Let us confess our faith in God. Please stand at your table for the one who does create, sustain, and empower us. Through the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty,
Creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in
Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord.
He was
conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church,
the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life. And also with you.
and also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
In the name of which you must betray, Jesus took bread. Give thanks and broke it.